Harvest is a critical time in the sugar industry. A mature sugar crop represents a big investment, and it's highly perishable. To maintain value, it's vital to get the harvested cane from field to mill without delay. At this time of year, because the pressure is on, because everyone is so busy, a cane field is a hazardous workplace. But it needn't be dangerous. No matter what you do during harvest, if you know about the hazards you face in your particular job and take the right precautions to control the risks, you'll be able to play your part in getting the crop from field to mill efficiently and safely. Workplace safety really is a state of mind. You can know all the rules and regulations, all the safety procedures, but the most important thing is your attitude. If you think safe, you'll work safe. But it goes further than that. On the job, you have legal obligations. If you employ other people, you must provide them with a safe, healthy workplace. You must supply them with safe equipment and proper training and supervision. And every person who enters your workplace, whether a full-time worker, a casual worker, or just a visitor, has a right to be protected from any hazards. That's the law. As a worker, you have a legal obligation to work safely. You have a legal obligation not to do anything that will endanger yourself or anyone else in the workplace. During harvesting operations, this means cooperation. Look after yourself. Look after your mates. It also means following procedures, wearing protective equipment when it's provided, and reporting any safety problems as soon as you can. Common sense, really. But remember, it's also the law. A well-laid-out, well-kept farm makes harvesting operations easier and safer. It's the grower's responsibility to maintain headlands and haul roads in good order. Cane growing close to roads, railway lines, and level crossings should be cut first to improve visibility and reduce the risk of accidents. Controlled burning means just what it says. Controlled burning. If a grower delegates the job to a harvesting crew,
righto, Reno, you're right to go, mate, she's all clear.
Clear, concise instructions should be given so that everybody knows what's expected. The end result? A safer burn. Every grower and harvesting contractor should have a farm map, which can be obtained from the mill. This can be used to carry out a risk assessment and then take steps to control any significant risks. As well as making harvest and haul out safer, a farm map properly used increases the efficiency of the entire operation. And that saves time and money.
We're going over the other side. The Mervyn's over there, across the drain.
Crews should always be briefed first. The briefing should include procedures regarding spillage and also what to do if there's a breakdown or an accident.
Everybody understood where we're at?
Yes,
right.
They should be provided with clear instructions about how to get to and from the harvesting and delivery point site.
And there's a pump shed here.
Any physical hazards should be pointed out. Hazards must be clearly identified, both by day and night. Night operations can be particularly hazardous. They should be told of any hazards specific to the day, rain-affected roads, for example, and any visitors who are expected. In some areas, radio systems are an important method of communication. Crews use them to advise of newly identified hazards and to avoid head-on collisions. Be responsible when you use your radio. Follow proper procedures. Here are the main points that should be covered at a pre-start briefing. Identify any hazards. Agree on the haul-out routes. And revise radio procedures. Safety starts at the beginning of each new shift. First up, make sure you're fit to be at work. That means a zero blood alcohol level. You must have received proper induction training for your particular machine. carry out the routine pre-start checks as specified in the operator's manual for your machine. Any worn or damaged parts should have been reported and replaced or fixed at the end of the previous shift. Climbing onto harvesters is potentially dangerous. Dew or rain make metal ladders very slippery. When climbing a ladder, always face the machine and maintain three-point contact. Let's go over some of the main points so far. Make sure you're fit for work. That means zero alcohol. Make sure you've had proper training for your machine. Read the instruction manual. Don't skip the routine checks. Attend to any worn or damaged parts. Keep your machine clean and use the ladder, steps and platform provided. Take special care when you're reversing. Drive slowly. And continue to keep a sharp lookout at all times. On the way to the harvest site, stick to the route that you were given at the briefing. It's been chosen for a reason, so follow it, even if you know a shortcut. Always maintain a sharp lookout, making allowance for local conditions. Watch out for overhead power lines, stays and poles. Sloping terrain, poor visibility, wet weather and boggy ground can all affect safe operations. In the field, the key word is cooperation. Harvester and haulouts must work together to make sure that the cane is removed efficiently and safely. With two large heavy machines on the move and close, a collision can happen very quickly. Keep a constant check on the position of the haulout in relation to the harvester. Communicate. Use your radio, but avoid unnecessary chatter. Stop loading before billets start to spill. There have been many accidents involving harvesters, haulouts, and people on the ground. Most should never have happened. For a start, unauthorized people don't belong on a cane field during harvesting operations under any circumstances. They're a hazard. If you see someone who shouldn't be there, stop work and do something about it. People who do have legitimate business in the workplace should let you know that they're there. They should wear high visibility clothing, and they should stay at least 20 meters clear of any working machinery. Of course, some people just seem to have a death wish, so keep a sharp lookout. Here are some more main points. Follow your briefing. Keep a sharp lookout. Cooperate and communicate with your fellow workers, and take particular care with people on the ground. Before carrying out maintenance on a harvester, make sure that it's parked on flat ground. Switch off and remove the key. If a control panel isolation switch is fitted, isolate the control panel before leaving the cabin. Make sure that a fire extinguisher is available, checked and up to date. Before working underneath the harvester, place a block of wood under the mainframe beam, or use a stay on the lift ramp to prevent accidental lowering of the machine. Movement of the base cutter height lever out of neutral will drop the front of the machine. Take great care when handling and replacing cutting blades. Follow the manufacturer's instructions. During refueling, minimize the risk of sparks due to static discharge by keeping the hose nozzle in contact with the fuel tank filler and don't smoke. Cutting and grinding are hazardous procedures with significant risk of eye damage, permanent hearing loss, and if a disc fails, other serious injury. Make sure the cutting or grinding disc matches the speed rating of the tool. And protect yourself from electric shock by using some form of current protection device. If you're grinding in the field, keep clear of trash residue that could start a fire. If it's necessary to make checks with the engine running, work with someone else. One person stays with the controls while an assistant does the checking. Engine exhaust gas is dangerous. If you must run the engine in a shed, make sure there's a good supply of fresh air. To summarize the main points again, before carrying out any maintenance, park the machine on flat ground. Switch off the engine and remove the key. If a switch is fitted, isolate the cabin. Support the machine before working underneath it. Don't smoke during refueling. Wear personal protective equipment and use an assistant during operational checks, one person to stay with the controls. As with harvesters, haul-out safety starts at the beginning of each new shift. First, you must be fit for work. That means a zero blood alcohol level. You must have received proper induction training for your particular machine. Carry out the routine pre-start checks as specified in the operator's manual for your machine. Any worn or damaged parts should have been reported and replaced or fixed at the end of the last shift. Before you climb aboard, walk around your machine. Check for obstructions and people. Take special care when you're reversing. Drive slowly. Sound the horn before you drive off. On the way to the harvest site, stick to the route that you were given at the briefing. It's been chosen for a reason, so follow it, even if you know a shortcut. Keep a sharp lookout, especially near public roads and railways, particularly early in the season, when fully grown cane can severely restrict visibility. As always, communicate. Use your radio to advise other crew members of changed conditions and other vehicles on the road. In the field, as we've said before, the key word is cooperation. Harvester and haulout should work together as a team to make sure the cane is removed efficiently and safely. Entry and exit routes to fields and delivery sidings must be worked out in advance, preferably at the briefing, and holding points agreed, so that there's no possibility of confusion or worse, collision. Teamwork is particularly important now. Both drivers need to have complete understanding, because with two machines operating so close together, collision is an ever-present possibility. A haul-out driver must keep a constant check on the position of the haul-out in relation to the harvester. With heavy machines like these, even minor collisions can cause severe and costly damage. If necessary, use your radio. Don't overload your haul-out. Overloaded haulouts can exceed the legal axle limits and cause spillages, which represent lost income for both grower and harvester. Spilt billets are also a safety hazard on the road. If a spill does happen, advise the whole crew by radio. Billets that may be a hazard should be removed as soon as possible by the driver responsible for the spill. Heading towards the delivery siding, match your speed to the local conditions. Slow down on rough terrain. Be particularly careful when you're traveling across ditches and keep well away from the edge of banks. A large number of accidents occur when tractors roll, often because of excessive speed or when they're turning on slopes. To avoid rollover, always turn so that the hitch or articulation point is uphill with the front of the tractor downhill. And avoid overloading. it reduces stability on hills. Another cause of accidents is fatigue. Manage fatigue by taking regular rest breaks. It's time to recap some more main points. Make sure you're fit for work. Zero alcohol. Make sure you've been properly trained. Read the instruction manual. Follow the directions given at your briefing. Drive according to the conditions. Keep a sharp lookout while driving. Be especially careful to avoid rollover on sloping ground. Cooperate, communicate. And if you're fatigued, tell your boss. At harvest time, cane railway sidings are particularly hazardous because they're shared workplaces. Harvesting crews and growers cross paths here. They all have one common goal: to get the cane in as quickly, as efficiently, and as economically as possible. But because they work for different organizations, there's plenty of potential for misunderstanding. And misunderstanding can lead to accidents. Once again, cooperation and communication are the key. At a delivery siding, it's vital to see and be seen. Radio equipment is one way of providing advance warning of hazards. If it's fitted to your haulout, use it. If a locomotive is already shunting when you arrive, it has right of way. You must wait for it to finish. If you are working in the siding when a train arrives, you have right of way, and the locomotive crew must wait for you. There are many ground hazards in a delivery siding. Wrongly set or clogged points, damaged rails, and spilt cane billets constitute a risk for both haulout and cane railway crews. It's the responsibility of the haulout crew to clean up spilt billets unless the spillage was caused by poor siding design. Before unloading, make sure the haulout is on level and stable ground. This is particularly important when you're moving with a bin raised. Never turn a haulout with the bin raised. And always make sure that the bin is lowered and the elevator door is closed before you leave the siding. Beware of power lines. For more about safety in delivery sidings, check out the video Delivery Point Safety in this series. Remember, a delivery siding is a shared workplace. Cooperation and communication are vital for safe operations here. See and be seen. Know who has right of way and keep the siding clean. Before carrying out maintenance on a haulout, make sure that it's parked on flat ground. Apply the parking brakes. Switch off the engine and remove the key to prevent anyone else from starting up while you're working on the machine. Make sure that a fire extinguisher is available. When you need to work underneath a cane haulage vehicle, use a wide base jack with enough capacity for the load. Never use makeshift lifting gear. Use blocks for extra support. Removing and refitting tires can be dangerous. Follow the manufacturer's instructions, and if in doubt, call a tire fitter. Always service a haulout vehicle on level ground. Stop the engine and remove the key. Support the vehicle when you're working underneath. Don't smoke during refueling. And take care when removing and repairing tires. During checks with the engine running, use an assistant. One person should stay with the controls. In harvesting and haulout operations, if you think safe, you'll work safe. Safety really is a state of mind. Cooperation and communication are the key. Your commitment to safe practice will contribute to a safety record that everyone in the sugar industry can be proud of. Harvest is a critical time in the sugar industry. A mature sugar crop represents a big, highly perishable investment. To maintain value, it's vital to get the cane from field to mill without delay. At this time of year, cane delivery sidings are busy workplaces. Harvesting contractors, locomotive operations, and growers all cross paths here with one common goal: to get the cane to the mill as quickly, as efficiently, as economically, and as safely as possible. Because different parties are involved, there's plenty of potential for misunderstanding. So a delivery siding can also be a hazardous workplace, but it needn't be a dangerous workplace. No matter what your job, no matter what haul-out method you use, if you know about the hazards you're likely to face and take the right precautions to control the risks, you'll be able to play your part in getting the crop from the field to the mill efficiently and safely. Workplace safety really is a state of mind. You can know all the rules and regulations, all the safety procedures, but the most important thing is your attitude. If you think safe, you'll work safe. But it goes further than that. On the job, you have legal obligations. If you employ other people, you must provide them with a safe, healthy workplace. You must supply them with safe equipment and proper training and supervision. As a worker, you have a legal obligation to work safely. You have a legal obligation not to do anything that will endanger yourself or anyone else in the workplace. Look after yourself, look after your mates. And every person who enters your workplace, whether a full-time or casual worker, has a right to be protected from any hazards too. That's the law. During harvest, a delivery siding is a busy shared workplace. So cooperation, communication, and common sense are the keys to safe, efficient operations. No matter what you're driving, the golden rule is see and be seen. Narrow headlands and high cane growing close to roads and railway lines can restrict visibility. Warn other operators of your presence by using your headlights, horn, and flashing lights. But go easy on the horn. Don't use it unnecessarily. Trains and haulouts must not operate in a delivery siding at the same time. As well as being unsafe, it's inefficient. So who has right of way? It's like having a haircut, really. Just a matter of waiting your turn. If a locomotive is already shunting when a haulout arrives, the locomotive crew has right of way. The haulout driver must wait for them to finish. On the other hand, if a haulout is working in the siding when a train arrives, it has right of way, and the locomotive crew must wait. What happens if train and haulout arrive at the siding simultaneously? Well, remember, it's not a competition. Cooperation is the key to safe working. And to cooperate, you have to communicate. Don't assume that the other person knows what you want to do or what you're thinking. Accidents are often caused by simple misunderstandings. A locomotive may enter a delivery siding to pass another locomotive or take a meal break. But once again, a haulout already working in the siding has right of way. And it must stay well clear of any bins in the siding. When operating a cane train in the vicinity of a delivery siding, safe operation should be top priority. Again, communication is the key. Use your lights and horn. Keep a close watch for obstacles and other traffic. Take particular care if you see a harvester operating close to the track. He may not have seen you. If the harvester isn't where he's supposed to be, tell the traffic office so the information can be passed on to other crews. Locomotive crews are responsible for the correct shunting and placement of empty bins.
Right to pull away rod to clear the roadway.
When shunting, make sure that the rake doesn't block roads. If necessary, separate the rake to provide vehicle access. Don't leave bins where they'll activate flashing crossing lights. When delivering empty bins to a siding, make sure that the bins remaining on the running line are chocked. Always chock bins before coupling or uncoupling them. Chocked bins are safer because they can't move unexpectedly. Even so, be on the lookout for sudden movement. You're particularly vulnerable when your body is between the bins, but you can reduce the risk by turning sideways. Never store bins on a running line, except during delivery and pickup. In a siding using the roll-on, roll-off system, separate lines are required for empty and full bins. Place empty bins only on the designated empty bin holding line, and make sure that they are within the marked clearance points. All empty bins must be chocked. If several harvesting contractors are operating at the siding, each will have his own line for full bins to maintain separation of consignments. If a bin has been derailed during shunting, it's the mill's responsibility to re-rail it. If a contractor derails a bin, then it's his responsibility. No matter who's responsible, it's important to remember that you're dealing with a perishable crop. It's in everyone's interest to get things moving again as soon as possible. After shunting, always reset the points to allow passage of trains on the main line. Always set turnout points leading to a bin dump towards the dump. And before you leave, store unused chocks parallel with the track and about 1 meter from it. Let's go over the main points for locomotive crews again. Cooperation and communication are the keys to safe working. Keep a sharp lookout for other traffic. Remember, the safe, correct shunting and placement of empty bins is your responsibility. Don't store bins across roads or on the main running line. Always chock bins. Maintain vehicle access to the siding at all times and reset points correctly before you leave. When operating an infield transporter, or any other vehicle in and around a delivery siding, safety should be your number one priority. It's vital to see and be seen. Keep a sharp lookout. And if a radio warning system is fitted to your haulout, watch for it to flash. Never race a train or cross the line ahead of a moving locomotive. Trains are heavy. They take a long time to stop and they can do a lot of damage. A loaded haulout is heavy too. Slow down. And remember, wet or slippery conditions increase braking distances. Haulouts can cross main lines only at designated crossing points. And don't get too close to the track. 2.5 meters is the minimum safe distance, further if possible. Within the siding, it's important to follow the right procedures for safety and efficiency. Make sure a locomotive is not in the siding, and that the driver's assistant is clear. All bins must be chocked to prevent unplanned and unexpected movement. During roll-on, roll-off operations, when full bins are returned to the siding, they must be recoupled immediately, and all empty bins must remain coupled as a rake until required for filling. Only haul-out units with approved pushing attachments are permitted to move bins within sidings. Don't improvise. Before unloading, make sure the haulout is on level and stable ground and that the tip of bin or elevator is raised. Slow down. This is particularly important when you're moving with a bin raised. Never turn a haulout with the bin raised. And always make sure that the bin is lowered and the elevator door closed before you leave the siding. Tipper and elevator bin operators must always fill bins in sequence, so that the oldest cane is available for collection first. There are many ground hazards in a delivery siding. Wrongly set or clogged points, damaged rails, and spilt cane billets are hazards for both haul-out and cane railway crews. As a member of a haul-out crew, it's your responsibility to clean up spilt billets unless the spillage was caused by poor siding design. Don't leave cane in heaps. And don't leave bins outside the designated clearance points. From time to time, bins derail. If this happens during haul-out operations, it's your responsibility to re-rail them. For safety, always follow the factory's documented re-railing procedures. Don't improvise. It leads to accidents. Here are the main points of responsibility for haul-out crews once again. Communication, cooperation, and a sharp lookout are vital for safe operations in a delivery siding. Don't race the train. Slow down. Restrain bins at all times. And remember, recoupling can be hazardous, so use the right procedure. Only approved haul-outs with approved pushing attachments can move bins, and bins must be filled in sequence. Tipper or elevator operators must always unload on level ground. Clear up spilt billets and reset points correctly. When they're working close to a delivery siding, harvester crews have safety obligations too. No harvester or haul-out vehicle should ever operate closer than 2.5 meters to the track. The traffic office should be advised of harvesting operations in advance and of elevators that protrude from the harvester so that locomotive crews can be notified. It's the harvester's responsibility. Harvest is a critical time in the sugar industry. A mature sugar crop represents a big, highly perishable investment. To maintain value, it's vital to get the cane from field to mill without delay. At this time of year, cane delivery sidings are busy workplaces. Harvesting contractors, locomotive operations, and growers all cross paths here with one common goal: to get the cane to the mill as quickly, as efficiently, as economically, and as safely as possible. Because different parties are involved, there's plenty of potential for misunderstanding. So a delivery siding can also be a hazardous workplace, but it needn't be a dangerous workplace. No matter what your job, no matter what haul-out method you use, if you know about the hazards you're likely to face and take the right precautions to control the risks, you'll be able to play your part in getting the crop from the field to the mill efficiently and safely. Workplace safety really is a state of mind. You can know all the rules and regulations, all the safety procedures, but the most important thing is your attitude. If you think safe, you'll work safe. But it goes further than that. On the job, you have legal obligations. If you employ other people, you must provide them with a safe, healthy workplace. You must supply them with safe equipment and proper training and supervision. As a worker, you have a legal obligation to work safely. You have a legal obligation not to do anything that will endanger yourself or anyone else in the workplace. Look after yourself. Look after your mates. And every person who enters your workplace, whether a full-time or casual worker, has a right to be protected from any hazards too. That's the law. During harvest, a delivery siding is a busy shared workplace. So cooperation, communication, and common sense are the keys to safe, efficient operations. No matter what you're driving, the golden rule is see and be seen. Narrow headlands and high cane growing close to roads and railway lines can restrict visibility. Warn other operators of your presence by using your headlights, horn, and flashing lights. But go easy on the horn. Don't use it unnecessarily. Trains and haul-outs must not operate in a delivery siding at the same time. As well as being unsafe, it's inefficient. So who has right of way? It's like having a haircut, really. Just a matter of waiting your turn. If a locomotive is already shunting when a haul-out arrives, the locomotive crew has right of way. The haul-out driver must wait for them to finish. On the other hand, if a haulout is working in the siding when a train arrives, it has right of way, and the locomotive crew must wait. What happens if train and haulout arrive at the siding simultaneously? Well, remember, it's not a competition. Cooperation is the key to safe working. And to cooperate, you have to communicate. Don't assume that the other person knows what you want to do or what you're thinking. Accidents are often caused by simple misunderstandings. A locomotive may enter a delivery siding to pass another locomotive or take a meal break. But once again, a haulout already working in the siding has right of way. And it must stay well clear of any bins in the siding. When operating a cane train in the vicinity of a delivery siding, safe operation should be top priority. Again, communication is the key. Use your lights and horn. Keep a close watch for obstacles and other traffic. Take particular care if you see a harvester operating close to the track. He may not have seen you. If the harvester isn't where he's supposed to be, tell the traffic office so the information can be passed on to other crews. Locomotive crews are responsible for the correct shunting and placement of empty bins.
Right to pull away rod to clear the roadway.
When shunting, make sure that the rake doesn't block roads. If necessary, separate the rake to provide vehicle access. Don't leave bins where they'll activate flashing crossing lights. When delivering empty bins to a siding, make sure that the bins remaining on the running line are chocked. Always chock bins before coupling or uncoupling them. Chocked bins are safer because they can't move unexpectedly. Even so, be on the lookout for sudden movement. You're particularly vulnerable when your body is between the bins, but you can reduce the risk by turning sideways. Never store bins on a running line, except during delivery and pickup. In a siding using the roll-on, roll-off system, separate lines are required for empty and full bins. Place empty bins only on the designated empty bin holding line, and make sure that they are within the marked clearance points. All empty bins must be chocked. If several harvesting contractors are operating at the siding, each will have his own line for full bins to maintain separation of consignments. If a bin has been derailed during shunting, it's the mill's responsibility to re-rail it. If a contractor derails a bin, then it's his responsibility. No matter who's responsible, it's important to remember that you're dealing with a perishable crop. It's in everyone's interest to get things moving again as soon as possible. After shunting, always reset the points to allow passage of trains on the main line. Always set turnout points leading to a bin dump towards the dump. And before you leave, store unused chocks parallel with the track and about 1 meter from it. Let's go over the main points for locomotive crews again. Cooperation and communication are the keys to safe working. Keep a sharp lookout for other traffic. Remember, the safe, correct shunting and placement of empty bins is your responsibility. Don't store bins across roads or on the main running line. Always chock bins. Maintain vehicle access to the siding at all times and reset points correctly before you leave. When operating an infield transporter or any other vehicle in and around a delivery siding, safety should be your number one priority. It's vital to see and be seen. Keep a sharp lookout. And if a radio warning system is fitted to your haulout, watch for it to flash. Never race a train or cross the line ahead of a moving locomotive. Trains are heavy. They take a long time to stop and they can do a lot of damage. A loaded haulout is heavy too. Slow down. And remember, wet or slippery conditions increase braking distances. Haulouts can cross main lines only at designated crossing points. And don't get too close to the track. 2.5 metres is the minimum safe distance, further if possible. Within the siding, it's important to follow the right procedures for safety and efficiency. Make sure a locomotive is not in the siding and that the driver's assistant is clear. All bins must be chocked to prevent unplanned and unexpected movement. During roll-on, roll-off operations, when full bins are returned to the siding, they must be recoupled immediately, and all empty bins must remain coupled as a rake until required for filling. Only haul-out units with approved pushing attachments are permitted to move bins within sidings. Don't improvise. Before unloading, make sure the haul-out is on level and stable ground, and that the tip of bin or elevator is raised. Slow down. This is particularly important when you're moving with a bin raised. Never turn a haul-out with the bin raised. And always make sure that the bin is lowered and the elevator door closed before you leave the siding. Tipper and elevator bin operators must always fill bins in sequence so that the oldest cane is available for collection first. There are many ground hazards in a delivery siding. Wrongly set or clogged points, damaged rails and spilt cane billets are hazards for both haul-out and cane railway crews. As a member of a haul-out crew, it's your responsibility to clean up spilt billets unless the spillage was caused by poor siding design. Don't leave cane in heaps. And don't leave bins outside the designated clearance points. From time to time, bins derail. If this happens during haul-out operations, it's your responsibility to re-rail them. For safety, always follow the factory's documented re-railing procedures. Don't improvise. It leads to accidents. Here are the main points of responsibility for haul-out crews once again. Communication, cooperation, and a sharp lookout are vital for safe operations in a delivery siding. Don't race the train. Slow down. Restrain bins at all times, and remember, recoupling can be hazardous, so use the right procedure. Only approved haul-outs with approved pushing attachments can move bins, and bins must be filled in sequence. Tipper or elevator operators must always unload on level ground. Clear up spilt billets and reset points correctly. When they're working close to a delivery siding, harvester crews have safety obligations too. No harvester or haul-out vehicle should ever operate closer than 2.5 metres to the track. The traffic office should be advised of harvesting operations in advance and of elevators that protrude from the harvester so that locomotive crews can be notified. It's the harvester's responsibility to keep the track clear of trash and leaves. No matter whether you drive a harvester, a haul-out vehicle, or a locomotive, when you work at a delivery siding, you're not just sharing a piece of real estate. You're sharing a responsibility to work safely. Safety really is a state of mind. It's up to you.